Yesterday was a typical example for our communist government to try to provocate a civil war in Belgrade or in Serbia because he wants to stay on his power. He has no alternatives to stay to be a president of Serbia because he has no more support of his people in Serbia.
Jedan narod trebalo bi u ljubavi, u slozi da rešavamo probleme, a ne nasiljem niti na neki drugi način, jer krv prolivena na ulicama Beograda ničemu ne vodi, ničemu dobrom ne služi.
Jučerašnji dan je pokazao da je režim gospodina Miloševića faktor krajnje nestabilnosti kako u regionu, tako i u našoj samoj zemlji, da on izaziva nemire, a da su demokratske demonstracije i demokratske stranke u Srbiji faktor stabilnosti. Jer samo izuzetnom uzdržanošću, izuzetnom strpljivošću uspjelo je da se izbegne šira konfrontacija. Mi nastavljamo naše mirne demonstracije jer želimo da te demokratske snage koje zahtevaju i poštovanje zakona i koje zahtevaju toleranciju, da one na kraju pobede u Srbiji.
Danas u Evropi Sloboda Milošević yesterday announced double war. The war against Western countries and the war against, according to him, domestic national traitors. It means democratic pro-European opposition zajedno, as well as students and all the people in Serbia who would like to have radical reforms in this country and to have Serbia involved in Europe.
Here because I have horrible memories of Jews being slaughtered and of the pogrom of 1929. And I fear that that is what is going to happen again when the PLO murderers, with Arafat the chief murderer, if they, God forbid, return to Hebron.
Mr. Sharon, you sure you don't want to react for AP?
Thank you.
Finally, Netanyahu made a positive step in the right, positive direction.
אמולכו.
We will be trying today to bridge the gaps that exist between us and our Israeli counterparts, and we hope that we can finalize. Please do not pressure us with time frames, when or how.
Let
אולי הם הרוויחו מזה שהם משכו את זה.